Hi, I'm Alan Hawes. Welcome to my new video series. I'm really excited today because I'm going to be showing you Amazon FreeRTOS working on a bunch of our new development kits. The kits I'm going to show you are called the Cypress CYW43907. Here one is right here. It's really cool. And I don't have one, but I'm also going to show you the CYW54907. I'll start out by telling you about the chips and the software tools that you can use to develop your own applications. And then I'll jump in to set up and run one of the complete Amazon FreeRTOS example application that sends and receives data from the cloud, which is, oh, by the way, the whole point of this IoT thing. The CYW43907 and CYW54907 are Wi-Fi MCU platforms that enable you to develop single chip Internet of Things applications. That's right, single chip. Our Wi-Fi and our MCU are together on the same chip. Both platforms have a 150 megahertz ARM 32-bit Cortex R4 core that's dedicated to run the Wi-Fi subsystem. This means that you don't have to deal with all of the crazy timing things that happen in the world of Wi-Fi because it's all running on that dedicated core. In addition, you have a 320 megahertz ARM Cortex R4 dedicated to your host application. That's right, one chip can handle Wi-Fi as well as your application all at the same time in the same chip. Both the 54907 and the 43907 have 2 megabytes of RAM to support memory intensive applications such as audio or other applications that need large buffers for high speed data transfer. They both have a bunch of onboard peripherals to allow you to interface with lots of different sensors and actuators for whatever your IoT thing is. Yeah, that's one of the weird things in this whole IoT thing is the thing can be a thing, so you end up with all kinds of crazy things you have to say. The CYW43907 is a 1x1 IEEE 802.11 ABGN dual band 5 gigahertz and 2.4 gigahertz Wi-Fi. The CYW54907 adds IEEE 802.11 AC on top of everything else that you get in the 43907. The faster AC speed is not typically critical for IoT devices. Who cares how fast your toaster pops up? But there's other advantages that do benefit IoT, such as extended range with beamforming and added power efficiency by quickly executing your wireless transactions before going into sleep mode. We say internally AC for IoT. The way you save power in IoT systems is you wake up, you do the thing that you need to do, you read the sensor or whatever, and then very quickly you turn on the radio, you transmit, and then you go back to sleep. And that's the point of AC. Really, the best reason to use these chips is that life is too short for flaky Wi-Fi. And there's a huge difference between some random Wi-Fi chip that you get from, you know, some random catalog house. They'll work okay on your desk, you know, sitting right next to your computer. Or maybe they'll work well in your lab, but when you put them into the real world, your product is destined for a bunch of bad Amazon reviews. Oh, you know, it doesn't work right. My network falls apart. You know, all of those horrible things are created by flaky Wi-Fi, and that's something which you definitely want to avoid. For all of these videos, I'll use the CYW43907, but both the 43907 as well as the 54907 are qualified for Amazon FreeRTOS. Even better, we support both chips with pre-certified modules delivered through one of Cypress's wireless module partners, such as Murata, USI, and Inventec. The kit that we'll be using today is the CYW43907 AEVAL1F. I know that's a boatload of letters and numbers, but those marketing people, they just get out of control and they're like way too clever for their own good. This kit comes with a certified CYW43907 Type 1 GC module from Murata that supports either a printed circuit board antenna or an optional external antenna. It has a micro USB port for programming and debugging, and it has Arduino headers that allow you to expand your project through the Arduino Shield ecosystem. In some of the videos, we'll be using an Arduino-compatible Shield board from Cypress. The CY8C-Kit-032 PSOC analog front-end shield comes with several environmental sensors on it, and those include temperature, humidity, ambient light, as well as a potentiometer. The board has four CapSense buttons, a CapSense proximity sensor, a 128x64 graphics OLED display, plus a pair of buttons and LEDs. Okay, that's it for the introduction of the Cypress CYW43907 and CYW54907 platforms. In the next video, we'll talk a little bit about the Amazon FreeRTOS ecosystem. You can post your comments and questions in our developers community. Or as always, you're welcome to email me a personal comment or question at alan_hawes@cypress.com or tweet me at AskIoTExpert with your comments, suggestions, criticisms, and questions. Thank you.